What is up, everyone? Welcome back to LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. It's getting a bit warm in here because my computer's been running, actually consuming a decent amount of CPU and GPU usage, and it heats up a bit, and yeah, it's summer and all of that. But anyway, enough about that. Let's go ahead and continue the story. And there it goes. Okay, so here we have the little intro crawl. Let's see what it's going to be. It's chapter 3. It's going to be Falcon Flight. Another ship one. But hey, we get to be the Millennium Falcon, which in some regards is a pretty cool ship. In some regards, isn't the coolest. Because, so it's not super cool because it only fires a single shot at one time. Like an X-Wing fires four at the same time, and I'm not sure if it does more damage, but it definitely looks cooler. But the cool thing about the Millennium Falcon is it has bidirectional, it has multi-directional firing range. So if there's no enemies inside, it'll just fire forward. But if there are enemies nearby, it'll fire anywhere around it to hit the enemies. So it's pretty cool, because you got TIE fighters on your tail, just hold down your fire button and they'll be gone. Okay, so here we go. We need to see what's here. Take out these things. It's perfect. You see what I mean? Did you see that bit? See that? Oh yeah. Oh boy, and we're taking some damage. This is a bit painful. Ooh, 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 ooh. Can we just go behind here? Hang on. Where is it? It's right there. Yeah. Oh gosh. We're dead. Looks like we dropped coins that time. Or studs. Or whatever you want to call them. Okay, and there we go. Close it down. Let's see here. See how it's, following the enemies. By the way, we have this red brick detector. But, it would be really nice to have that minikit detector. But I don't know what level it's on. So I'm not sure how plausible it would be to get that. How realistic it would be. But yeah, there goes a TIE interceptor, thanks to our multi-directional firing range. Okay, yeah. Wait, hang on. Are we just going straight into the asteroid field? Is it safe to look up? Yeah, we're just going straight into the asteroid field. I thought we were gonna hide it behind the thing first, but I guess not. Behind the Star Destroyer, that's what I meant. And, okay, so here's the awkward thing about this, right? In fact, I remember doing test footage on this level and being a bit, as the Brits might say, a bit cheesed off at how it works, because you get your torpedoes from blowing up these asteroids. Sometimes they despawn before you actually get them, even though you're driving right by them. But hey, look at that, we're fine for now, so we'll go through, and we're also fine on True Jedi, so we'll just go on through and get that, and blow all this stuff up, and pjom, pjom, and pjom. Get our little stud action here, and take some damage. Oh no! Stop. Whew. I thought we were gonna die. Oh, okay. So it does actually fire two blasts at once, one on top and one on bottom. And I feel like the bottom one might always be forward. Yeah. So okay, I take that back. Millennium Falcon's a pretty cool ship. As far as ships in LEGO Star Wars go, it's a pretty cool one. Which is, handy, because it's a pretty cool ship in the normal Star Wars universe as well, so. Fits. Totally fits. Let's go ahead and take these guys out, and there's the other thing. The asteroids break into little smaller pieces, but the smaller pieces will not be blown up, right after they show up. They'll tumble around for a bit, and then they'll accept being blown up. But not before, apparently. And we'll go ahead and blow that up. Come on. There we go. It's a bit underwhelming, stud collection there. Okay, we're full on torpedoes again. Yeah, I feel like the torpedo collection here isn't that bad now. Maybe it was... Oh, I would have been in free play. I don't know. That should have, if anything, made it easier, because then I could be a higher capacity thing and not have to fill up as often. Maybe that was it, because, you know, you need to collect the same number of torpedoes anyway. You know, it's just how big of a torpedo collecting session do you want to have? And, of course, if you have more torpedoes in your arsenal, then you can blow up a full four-shot thing like this and still have some to spare. And look at that, we hit it after death. That's pretty cool, if you ask me. So now I just need one more torpedo, and then we will be golden. So let's find a little torpedo action, shall we? Okay, that's a torpedo. We'll go ahead and fill up, though, because, you know, why not? While we're in the neighborhood. And yeah, the torpedo collection, I remember it being a lot worse. That was, you know, I remember thinking it was a lot worse anyway. Maybe it was just in my head. I don't know. Let's go ahead and blow this up. Blow this up. Come on. There we go. And there, yeah. Don't even have to look at them to take them out. That's why the Millennium Falcon is pretty cool. Okay, and we will need to go back to get more. We don't have the source. Oh, look at all those studs. Oh, yes. Okay, then we'll just go ahead and blow that up. And, yeah, another one. And another lot of studs. Haha. Aw, yeah. That's amazing. We just got, like, at least 10,000 studs from those two. Because, you know, we had a lot of blue studs. And we had the blue stud score multiplier. Score doubler. So, I'd expect we got, like, 15 to 20,000 just from the blues alone. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Okay, so now we're full up. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and drop down into the little the space worm thing. Because I don't think it's part of the story, but it's definitely something you can do. And I feel like there might be some minikits down there or something. Yeah, so we'll just head down here, right? And then, yep, and that's, oh, it's a double score zone. Oh, and it's a source of, look at that. I didn't realize it was a source of, whatchamacallums? Torpedoes. There we go. Oh, yeah. Look at this. We're gonna be rich. We're gonna be the richest people in LEGO Star. Oh, and those do, wait, hang on. Looks like those things that we blow up come back. I don't even know what we're blowing up, though. Those are like parts of ships right there. They just arbitrarily become re-blow-upable. That's crazy. This is like an infinite stud source. But we don't need infinite studs because we have plenty of ways to get studs for now. We'll just go ahead and exit. Yeah, don't mind us. Yeah, I didn't remember that being a source of photon torpedoes. That's pretty cool, if you ask me. Let's go ahead and magnet up these studs, and you know, you notice once those structures get down to one torpedo left, then they start to shake a bit. It's kind of funny. There we go. Let's go ahead and get those. Oh, okay. Wait. They did disappear that time. Okay, yeah, they're coming back. Hang on. You blow them up a second time. Oh, weird. Okay, so the first time you blow them up, right, they disappear. And then they come back. But they come back permanent. So they, even when you blow them up, they just stick there. Pretty sure that's a glitch. Pretty sure that's not intended behavior, because that's pretty weird behavior to intend. Boom. Yeah, and we didn't take any damage from that. That's pretty cool. I like not taking damage from things. It's one of my favorite pastimes. Let's see, we just need one more? Yeah, seriously. Oh, okay, hang on. No, I remember. Okay, when I was running the test footage of that, of this level, I remember what I was having trouble with. It's this thing. Okay, it's not that bad yet. Okay, wait. Yeah, okay. It's still that. When you get too close, and the border is arbitrary and invisible. You don't know how close is too close. You just have to guess. When you get too close, you die instantly. You don't get, like, transported back. You die. And, you know, it's basically impossible to tell how far is too far. So that's what I was annoyed at. Which is, I think, a pretty logical, reasonable thing to get annoyed at. Yeah. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. There we go, there we go. Die. All the TIE fighters must die. Oh, awkward. Glitched inside that asteroid and then blew it up by being inside it. It's a bit weird, if you ask me. I feel like I'm saying "if you ask me" a lot in this episode. For whatever reason, I don't know. If you ask me, it's pretty ridiculous. You know? Sometimes I'm so not funny, it's funny. Maybe, I don't know. I think that's the case. Maybe you guys think I'm just being ridiculous. So, you know, you can always let me know in the comments down below. If you're so inclined. Yeah. Oh. Go. Did we actually fire that? I'm pretty sure. Come on. Come on, hit the thing. Okay, where's the last one? Ugh. Die. Okay, there we go. Is that the last one? Yes! Last one! Yeah! Hallelujah! Okay, right, and then it's the cinematic bit. Okay, so we get through the asteroid field, and then is that how it happened in the movie? I wouldn't even remember. If you remember, I would be curious to hear. And then, you know, this emphasizes the difference in scale of the different things, because, like, the dots on the Star Destroyer are, like, this big, and then the one on the Millennium Falcon, this big. It's kind of funny. Okay, and then this is funny. Okay, look at that, a shopping cart, all this random junk, and then... But why isn't he... Doesn't he make a sound? It's just like... But it's just like... Score X4! Oh, snap. Okay. This is gonna be great. Although, I'm pretty sure I won't be able to afford it, because I'm pretty sure they go up in price according to the relative multiplication of the score. So, like, the Score X4 is gonna be, I think, twice that of the Score X2. And the Score X2, I think, was, like, 1.2 million. So, you can see, we're, like, halfway there. So, yeah, it'll be a bit of time before we can do that. But, yeah, that's going to be it for now. I actually think I'll probably call that good for recording and do another little, two-session recording of an episode. But actually, okay, while we're in the neighborhood, since we're not continuing the story right this minute, let's go ahead and head over to the shop and see how much that score multiplier X4 is. Yeah, let's see that. Start over here. Yeah, we still have exploding blaster bolts on. Look at that. I didn't even pay attention to if it made a difference in the ship ones. Let's see. Here we go. Ooh, little hiccup thing. So there's that X2. That must be like super blasters or something. There's the Score X2. There's something else X2. That's probably fast build. Maybe? Then the Score X4. Yeah. 2.5 million. So we're a bit off, guys. Oh, and that's probably... regenerate hearts, maybe? Or maybe even invincibility. Okay, there's going to be the minikit detector. So in 2 chapters... I wonder if I'll remember it. 2 chapters is the thing. That'll be super zappers, probably. Yeah. And bounty hunter rockets. That's always a fun one. Yeah. So Score X10 is going to be the last power-up. Okay, so I guess I'll, in 2 episodes, or 2 chapters, I'll try, if I remember, I'll definitely be more attentive to see if I can find that red brick and access it in story. But yeah, that's it from me, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, definitely be sure to hit that thumbs up button. Leave me a comment down below if you have something to say. Comment Wait. Share it with your peeps. I already said comment. Share it with your peeps if you think they would enjoy it. And subscribe if you're new around here. Catch you in the next one, guys.